को
वेरी गुड संडे आफ्टरनून द एस्टीम्ड चीफ गेस्ट फॉर टुडे द ऑनरेबल एनर्जी मिनिस्टर श्री सौरभ भाई पटेल फैकल्टी फॉर द फर्स्ट सेशन सीए जतिन जलाल चेयरमैन अहमदाबाद ब्रांच सीए हरित धारीवाल ट्रेजरर सीए सुनील संघवी कोऑर्डिनेटर फॉर टुडेज सेशन सीए पक्षल पटेल सीनियर मेंबर्स एंड माय डियर फ्रेंड्स वेलकम टू दिस थर्ड डे ऑफ द फर्स्ट एवर फोर डेज नेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस ऑन एमएसएमई आफ्टर अ वंडरफुल स्टार्ट ऑन फर्स्ट डे बाय अवर प्रेसिडेंट एंड वाइस प्रेसिडेंट Yesterday also we had a chief guest from Bank of Baroda and today on Sunday afternoon more than 300 participants have joined and we are really grateful to the Energy Minister Saurabh Bhai Patel for joining us. We welcome you sir, a very warm welcome from the Secretary of Ahmedabad Branch CA Anjali Choksi. Continuing our rich tradition of starting the session with ICI motto, I request each one of you to place your right hand on your heart for ICI motto.
Yaresha sukte shujagrati. कामं 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 कामुषो पुरुषो निर्मिमाणः निर्मिमाणः तदेव शुक्रं तदेव शुक्रद्ब्रह्मा तद्ब्रह्मा तदेवामृतमुच्यते
Welcome back. The ICI motto says itself, when everybody is sleeping, we are all awake, and that's the testimonial of the Sunday afternoon. Taking the session ahead, a happy International MSME Day to all of you. Today also in Mann Ki Baat, the Prime Minister has wished us in advance a happy CA Day, which is coming on 1st July. So in advance, happy CA Day to all of you. Taking the session ahead, I would now request Chairman C. Harit Dhariwal to give opening remarks for the third day and take the session ahead.
Thank you, Anjali Ben. Very respected Cabinet Minister of Energy, Shri Saurabh Bhai Patel, sir. The faculty for our first session, Jatin Bhai Jajal, joined us from Rajkot. Treasurer of the branch, Sunil Bhai Sanghvi, Secretary Anjali Ben, the coordinators, Prakshal, Saurabh, and Sameer, and all the participants who have joined us. We see more than 350 participants who have already logged in, and soon they'll be joining in. We have more than 1,200 registrations for this four-day national conference. Wishing you all a very happy International MSME Day. I was just talking to sir that the conference, which was supposed to happen only on today, one day, became a four-day national conference because we wanted to cover all the important topics. And today is a very special day. Apart from being the International MSME Day, we will all get a chance to hear from someone who is a prolific speaker, but at the same time, very knowledgeable person. Sir, we are always, you know, it's a pleasure to hear you. And today we are all waiting to hear your views on the MSME sector, sir. And without taking much of the time, I would straight away request Sunil Bhai to briefly introduce sir before we can hear. Thank you.
Thank you, Chairman Harit Bhai. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the day three of the MSME series. We are having with us Chief Guest, Sri Saurabh Bhai Patel, Energy Minister, Government of Gujarat, and who is a member of Gujarat Legislative Assembly since 1998, that is almost 23 years, very senior and experienced leader, and the person who has successfully implemented the VAT Act that we all very well know. Sir has served as a minister in charge of various departments during his tenure, like energy and petrochemicals, mines and minerals, finance, cottage industry, planning, tourism, civil aviation, labor and employment, and many. Sir has successfully implemented Jyoti Gram Yojana, a scheme of the government of Gujarat, which provides 24 hours continuous three-phase quality power to all the rural area, that is 18,065 villages and its peripheral of the Gujarat. Sir has transferred Gujarat into the energy hub of the nation by implementing the power projects with installed capacity of more than 38,000 megawatt. Sir has also a key role in the field of green energy solar projects. There is a very long list of the projects led by the sir during his career, and many achievements are there. But we are here to hear the sir, and not wasting time further, we welcome you, sir, and let's have a big round of applause for the sir. Sir, there is a long list. I am not reading the entire one, sir, and I request you, sir, to address the august audience now, sir.
Good afternoon to everyone who is joining today. First, my congratulations to the organizers for organizing this event. 3-day event is not a small thing. And I understand it's going to be a 4-day event. So people do join only if something comes out from the seminar. And I'm sure a lot of MSE entrepreneurs must have learned something from this event of yours. Now, coming back, Gujarat is the base for MSME. A lot of entrepreneurs are over here in the state of Gujarat and looking out for opportunities for investment, looking out for roadmaps, looking out for learning something. If you look at India, India is growing even in this pandemic. There have been people who have found something and found new opportunities of growth. Now you come back in the state of Gujarat, my energy consumption before was 130 million units per day. Today, it is more than 130, even in these times. So that means there are shutdowns everywhere in India, but the industry today is running at more than 130 MUs. It is 138 MUs per day today. So there is no industrial shutdown. There is no production loss. And if you look at the economy as a whole in the state of Gujarat, it is better. Our revenue is also pretty good. Our agriculture output is also pretty good. Our MSME consumption is also good. So overall, when you talk of the country and you talk of the state of Gujarat, I think we are better off than other states, in spite of the fact that we had the second virus, which was very strong, and we checked, affected practically every family in the state of Gujarat. Now, MSME is the backbone of our economy. In our GDP also, the share of MSME is too big. And no state government can ignore this strong presence of MSME sector. More important, MSME sector not only helps employment. Today, after agriculture, I understand the MSME gives the maximum number of employment, but more it helps in social development. The increase per capita income, MSME has a big role. If there is one MSME, the incomes of an individual increases many, many times. So even in the smallest rural area, one MSME helps in not only social development, but also improving the incomes of that individual or the incomes of that family in that particular area. Today, if you look at MSME in the state of Gujarat, no doubt the clusters are formed. Ahmedabad, biggest chunk of MSME, Baroda, Surat, Rajkot, Jamnagar. So MSMEs are usually developed near urban areas. But lately, if you observe, because of the policies of the government of Gujarat, a lot of MSCs have developed even in the local areas. So this policy also, we have given a lot of advantages or a lot of incentives for development of MSME if they come up in rural areas also. Now, if you observe that lately, education have grown in a big way, say after 2000, in the last 10 years, 15 years. The education in rural areas have grown and every person has started studying, especially women entrepreneurs. Many of them are coming from rural areas. This is because the thrust which the government has given to education in the rural area. Now, the efforts these students have done to get a good education, they desire to do something. They want to get a good job in a multinational company. They want a good job in a private company. They want to start, have their own startup. They want to work. And this is the strength of our country. And this young population is going to drive the GDP growth for years to come in India and even in the state of Gujarat. Now, if you look at MSME, I think I would talk about my sector first, and then if I have time, I'll talk about the sectors. Now, let's look at MSME and energy. Now, people say that the cost of energy is very high. Yes, in the state of Gujarat, we get the coal from very far off places. The cost of variable cost is much higher than the fixed cost that has resulted into. But if you compare apple to apple, okay, there are places, areas where the variable cost is low. Then also the cost of energy in those places is much, much higher. For an industry, let's talk of Bombay or let's talk of Delhi or let's talk of any other big towns or industries, and you compare it with the state of Gujarat. I think we are very, very competitive if you compare our energy cost with the cost in those areas. Second point is that consistency in giving power. We are very, very consistent and we have a very good sound regulatory system where anyone can go and if there is an issue, they can go and go to the regulator and make an issue out of it. So a sound regulatory system is also present in the state of Gujarat. And today, we are not asked for at any given time for an increase in tariff. Only thing what increase comes in is because of the variable cost, because of the increase in the freight or the increase in fuel or that cost. But to see to it that MSME doesn't suffer, we have come out with a solar policy. Now, this solar policy, the new policy in 2021, have removed all the capacity ceilings. That means that any person, any MSME can put up any unit anywhere in the state of Gujarat, even on his roof, consume the power, use it, and whatever surplus remains can sell it. He cannot bank it. We are not saying that you sell it to us and make profit. No, that's not the objective. The objective is very simple, that whatever power you generate from 7 in the morning to 6 in the evening, you have to use it that particular time. And for that, within that span, if anything remains, we are ready to buy 2.25 per unit, which I think would be the cost of slightly similar to your cost. Now, what is the advantage? The advantage is you get a saving of at least ₹3 to ₹4 per unit on your consumption. So what we want to do is we want you to generate that power, use that power and save ₹3 to ₹4 depending upon the location and depending upon the cost. So I think this policy of MSME, no state in the country has given 100% capacity ceilings to MSME. And I think this, in the days to come, will positively help. Rooftop, today, we are the number one in the country. Today, any individual or any person in the country and in the state of Gujarat can put a rooftop and use it for its own consumption. For residential, we give up to subsidy of 40%, depending upon your capacities. But today, 709 megawatts, total 185,000 people have started rooftop, highest in the country, and 709 megawatts of people or clients have started using the rooftop policy. Now, what I feel in the energy sector, times are changing. Technology is coming very fast. So we started renewables about 10, 15 years back at 15 rupees a unit. Last bid which we came was 1.99, which was one of the most efficient in the whole country. Today, in last couple of years, we have tied up 3,750 megawatts of solar renewable bids for the people, 700 for the wind. Now, because to push Atmanirbhar packages, to push production in the state of Gujarat or in the state, in the country, the government of India has come out with some customs duty, I would say, trying to protect the local industry. And for that, the tariff might increase by 20-30 paisa. But in the longer run, I think that will be a blessing in disguise in the country. Today, Adani is coming up with a very big industrial investment in the state of Gujarat. Tata is also thinking of coming up. There are another couple of parties. And 2 days back, Mukesh Ambani has announced something big. And what he has announced, 1 lakh megawatt by 2030. So that means next 6-7 years. I think what he has announced, and Reliance, when they usually announce, they implement it. They have announced the storing capacities in energy sector, renewables. Now, storing is the biggest challenge. Because when we talk of renewables, we talk of morning to evening. Now, what is talk of storing? Battery storage. So I think the days in next 3-4 years, there is going to be a drastic change in renewables sector, even in the energy sector, because of the mega announcement made by Reliance 2 days back. Now, investing 60,000 crores in Jamnagar, 60,000 crores, a lot of money in this sector. Now, usually announcement were made by everyone of photovoltaic cell. Now he's starting from A to Z. Usually investments, wafers were imported and then manufacturing started. But when you start from scratch, it will be very competitive. Now over here, people bid it at 1.99 by importing from China cells. Now imagine when Reliance starts, we have experienced that in Jio, we experienced that in other fields. Now what I see a different picture emerging after 3 years in the state of Gujarat or in the country as a whole, when such massive capacities come up in the energy. So I personally feel that out of 3-4 years, the cost of energy will reduce drastically. The days of thermal are practically over if huge capacities of storing comes up in the country. And the days of 4 rupees or 5 rupees or 6 rupees will be over by 2030. And if you want to sell 1 lakh megawatts, that means you have to have a drastic reduction in prices. Then and then only people are going to buy. So I see those days after this announcement, hydrogen announcement was also there. So the whole fundamental change we foresee, the vision of Honorable Prime Minister, which for 450 gigawatts by 2030, now I think that will start shaping. And it will be coming up in a very big way in next 2-3 years. Maybe the days of this transmission network and grids, maybe next 5-7 years, you might not be requiring it also. huge capacities expenditure in the transmission network. Because once storage comes in, and if storage is cheap, then I don't think anything is required, such capital expenditure is required in the transmission network. So energy is going to make a lot of changes in the next 2-3 years. Today, if you look at the issues in the MSME sector, what I foresee is, first is the financing cost. I don't know what BOB, Bank of General, but to compare it with large industries, the financing cost of an MSME is comparatively higher. Second, when I always meet the top persons in the banking sector, I tell them that there are towns like Ahmedabad, Rajkot, Jamnagar, Bhavnagar, where you should have a big MSME sector where the cost, where people don't have to run to every branch. If you simplify the financing, ease of doing business for an MSME, especially they not only give assurances, the plans, but the personal guarantees involved, many a time that is very difficult. So giving a personal guarantee for an investment. So the plant, machinery, land, building, it's okay, fair enough. But crossing personal guarantees and unlimited personal guarantees is one of the biggest challenges facing this sector. Second is, I think we require a strong MSME institution. Say, for example, for big ones, CI is there, FICCI is there. They take up the issues of the central government. There is not a single big, powerful, strong institution for the MSME to take up the issues in the government, whether it's center or whether it is the state. So those small sector institutions have to represent only and only MSME. They should not represent big ones and small ones also. And usually all the associations, they come out with a lot of good ideas and good suggestions, but usually they are more beneficial to big ones rather than small ones. Big ones have a lot of brothers, big brothers. But small ones, they don't have much handholding people. People in rural areas, their issues, their fundamentals, the things. Who's there to represent? So we should, and I'm not saying represent, I'm saying making a good policy suggestion for the beneficial of this small people. So an institution is positively required, strong one. Today, if you look at most of the estates, GIDC has to build in a person staying. He requires an estate, requires an infrastructure near his house. He cannot afford, a person living in Ahmedabad cannot afford going away more than 60 kilometers away. He has to himself reach the manufacturing place every day or practically 4 days a week to see whether his plant is running properly or not. He cannot have very high-ended professionals, say, for example, Gujarat, say, Dahej, big estate, bigger. Most of the units are big units and all professionals. Investments from all over India is there. MSME, hardly any. Now, Dholera, small units, presence won't be there. Only big units. So the estates which have been big estates are developing, have investments only from big people. Small estates and nearby big towns or small towns, investment only comes from people who can be present. So such in estates, government, we are developing, and I think more and more should be developed in the days to come. And this will give more and more employment nearer small towns and nearer big towns also. Government policies, we are more aggressive. We are also successful, say, for example, textile policy. I think it is one of the most successful policy for spinning. Today, earlier cotton used to go from here. Ginning was there, spinning was done in Tamil Nadu, used to come back for weighing over here, processing was done over here. So this freight cost and everything today, spinning capacities because this policy is the highest in the country. And I think now without any subsidy, new spinach capacities are coming up in the country because people have made money. They have started exporting from here to China and a lot of countries. And a group of people get together, put up 25,000 spindles. That is the strength of Gujarat. So these policies have been benefit. We have developed wonderful clusters. Clusters, ceramics is the biggest shining example of a cluster formation. Morbi is the strength in the whole world. Today, from here, ceramics, they go. People who have hardly had any in education, they have put up big ceramic units where we are proud of. Today, I'm saying that today, being an energy minister, I put up 8 to 10 substations every year in Morbi, and the capacities get over. Today, Honorable Chief Minister has put up a GIDC estate in Morbi, but by the time applications will open, it will get over. So today we are competing China in the biggest and biggest markets. And the young generation, we are very highly educated and technically sound, have taken over from their parents, from their father and uncles. So a group of people get together, form a unit and produce the best. So the cluster formation have been very successful. Ceramic, the diamonds sector, there also we are the best. Gems and jewelry also, we are the best. Chemicals, we are doing very well. That also, we are very good. Pharmaceuticals, also we are very good. But I think we should concentrate more and more on service sector, because that is sector is going to give a lot of employment. So if development of service sector, if in the people service sector have good ideas, I think they should come to government. See, gift is a vision of our honorable Prime Minister, and I think it will give a lot of employment in the, especially to your faculty, chartered accountants, cost accountants. I think nowhere in the country can get a better employment than the gift. So that such areas have to be developed by us jointly with a lot of idea sharing. And this ideas can be given by strong institutions, because this is the way forward for GIFT. This is the way forward for service sector, because high end employment is possible only through the service sector now. So I think skilled manpower, we are working through a lot of ITIs, but still it's a challenge because the industry is one step ahead of the requirements than the government, because government cannot find out every day that what are the new facilities which come in. So it has to be a partnership between the industry and the government to get the best skilled manpower available. And whatever ITIs which we come out with, they are immediately absorbed by the industry. There are good multinational companies, Maruti and everyone have partnered with the government for production, for giving better skilled manpower. So I think skilled manpower is also one of the challenges, and I think we'll be able to come up with it jointly. Policies, capital, I think there's a special subject, so I don't want to mention on that subject because a lot of the MSMEs do get a job. But I'll tell you one thing very honestly. A huge budget is being today given by the state government only for the promotion of industries, and MSME has got a big chunk. Today, the easiest, or I would not say the easiest, but our finance department gives the budget 3 months in advance so that all the industries get their incentives on schedule. This is not easy. I know states, I don't want to name the states, but they make a policy and they don't give incentives even for 2 years, 3 years. So when the industry plans their capital requirement, they always look out for incentives and subsidies from the government. on schedule. And when they don't get it, they get into working capital problems. So this is the reason why people come to the state of Gujarat, because they are assured of a good on schedule government in working capital incentives to be passed on. Now I think the future is going to be very bright. The reason is huge amount of money is spent on infrastructure. The roads, you say, is the finest. Power grid, I think no state has got a grid which is strong as us. The road is good, the power sector is good, the ports. I think our port policy has resulted into many private ports. And today, about 40% of the country's cargo passes through the state of Gujarat. If you look at Kandla and you look at private ports also. So this is our strength. So which saves time, it saves, I mean, you can go to anywhere in the country and look at other states and look at the state of Gujarat. The logistic parks and everything is very well established. And a lot of entrepreneurs, new ones, entrepreneurs, they come and invest. Even if they have had the finest of education in other states. But I know so many people who have come and put in the money and started the investments in the state of Gujarat. So manufacturing is our strength. We have to make services also our strength in the years to come. If we make services in the strength, then I think no one in the world can beat us. Agriculture, because of Narmada, the real incomes of our people have increased drastically. And there are so many young entrepreneurs in the agriculture sector who have added, started value addition. And even now, when you talk of value addition, you can see in rural areas, young entrepreneurs coming up with new MSME units, especially in the agriculture sector. So I think that is going to be also a strength. And after the increase in the height of Narmada Dam, water flows practically 365 days. So earlier we used to have one crop. Today, even summer, our farmers are able to use this water and cultivate their farms. So their incomes of people in the farming sector have also increased. So I think the future is bright. Our financial government's finances are much better than any other state in the country. We don't go to the center with every meeting. I know other states, and you might read in the newspapers, there are so many states asking for money from the center, from the smallest possible thing. Even in this corona, everyone suffered. The center suffered, the state suffered, the income suffered. But we, because of our financial strength, we never said to the center, you give us something more than what is our due. While other states always, say for example, Delhi. Delhi doesn't have any expense. What is there? Everything is earning. Say state of Gujarat, we have 8,000 crores of subsidy only to the agriculture sector. Well, Delhi, everything is earning. The best of people, the services, MSM is there, industries are there. There is no expense on the rural sector. If you talk of other states, say Maharashtra, yes, agreed. They have a big rural sector. Tamil Nadu rural sector, Gujarat rural sector, Madhya Pradesh rural sector, UP rural sector. But states like Delhi, I don't think they have anything to complain about. Because everything is positive, positive, positive as far as incomes are concerned. Only thing is spend your money where it is required. And you will do wonderful for the citizens. So challenges for Gujarat and challenges for other states are different. And we have come out with the challenge in a much better way than most of the states in the country. And with the strong support from the center, our MSME sector will flourish in the days to come. So I understand a lot of sessions are there today. I hope your this 4-day seminar will bring in a lot of benefits to the people. And if there are any questions regarding what I've said, you can positively email me the questions, and I'd love to answer those questions even through privately also. Thank you for inviting me to the seminar, and I wish you all success in the coming days, especially to the MSME sector and the chartered accountants. They are the best in the state, I'll tell you, and the best advice. And they advise so well that many of times after the advice, you have to make a lot of changes. And we are always willing to make those changes. So I wish them all success also. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir, for sharing the developments taking place in the energy sector. And we are glad that the government of Gujarat under your dynamic leadership is doing commendable work, whether it is solar energy, renewable energy, storage of renewable energy, the investments made by big corporates, the cost of energy sector going down, the fundamental and the technological changes taking place in the next 3 years. We are also thankful to you for sharing and throwing light on the issues on MSME with a strong need for MSME institutions, MSME estates, which can go a long way in development of MSME. We are also thankful that we have good Kastler developed in Morbi, Surat, with a need to focus on the service sector, port development, Narmada Dam, and many more. We are really privileged, sir, that we live in Gujarat. And under your genuine leadership, government of Gujarat is creating pathways for other states while scaling heights. We can say that Apdu Gujarat, Rudu Gujarat. Thank you so much. And from bottom of Ahmedabad branch of ICI, and there are more than 57 participants, we are really grateful for sparing your valuable time on this Sunday afternoon. We are really, really thankful. And I will request all of you to give a big round of applause for our sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Moving to the first session of the day. Before I start the first session, there is an announcement. Due to medical emergencies on the part of the second faculty, CA Vedant Parikh, we have rescheduled the session from 5 to 7 to Tuesday morning, 10:30 to 12:30. So kindly take note. And now you all can have a good Sunday evening. But yes, we have the first session to go, and our esteemed faculty is very much here, CA Jatin Jajalji from Rajkot. So without taking much time, immediately we start the first session. I would request CA Pakshal Patel to introduce the first faculty for today, CA Jatinji. Welcome, Jatinji.
Thank you. Thank you, Anjali ma'am. It's a pleasure introducing Jatin sir, because even his brief profile is so large, that means he has achieved so much, so many things and so many feats. So first of all, starting with education, he is a commerce graduate from Saurashtra University, and of course he has cleared chartered accountancy course, then post qualification course information system audit. He is also he is practicing as a chartered accountant in the field of finance, subsidy and taxation. He is visiting faculty at ICI Rajkot, Ahmedabad and Mumbai. He has also delivered lecture at Rajkot Chamber of Commerce, Imitation Jewelry Association and Mumbai Municipal Corporation. He has also written books on subsidies and investment in Gujarat. He is also represented ICI at Asian Financial Forum, Hong Kong. He was also invited to invest USA held Washington, USA in 2016. He has consulted industries and professionals at USA and Singapore. He was also chairman of Rajkot branch of Vikasa. After that, he was chairman of Rajkot branch of WRIC of ICI. And during his tenure, Rajkot branch has acquired 2-acre land for CA and CS students. And he is not only a professional, he is also a sports adventurer, and he has done world's largest bungee jumping, skydiving, and he is certified scuba diver. So this is a brief introduction of our prominent faculty, Jatin Jalal, sir. Over to you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much for your kind words. So MSME, when we have in our mind is the micro, small and medium enterprises. Whenever we are really thought of MSME, and that comes in my mind, is like that kid, you know, small units which are competing with the large unit. Isn't it like that? So, but still, there is a huge scope for the MSME. And I'm thankful to all of you that on a Sunday siesta, you all are here to hear me. Yeah, it's like wonderful. In Rajkot, it can't happen. So already 567 are listening to me. So I'm quite surprised. So I was actually talking to Harit that anyone is going to come at 3 o'clock. Because in Rajkot, it could be considered as an insult if you invite at 3 o'clock. So salute to all of you. However, yesterday Modi ji has covered a lot of topics actually. So at the midnight, I have to change my slides again because many of the things has been covered by him. So again, I have now started to go on a little deeper for the benefit of all our members. So let us start with the PowerPoint. And I request all the members to let it be a little interactive. In between, I will raise some questions, let you brainstorm, and let you discuss with all of us. Is it right? Can I, Harit bhai, go with that way?
Absolutely, sir.
Yes, thank you. So basically, MSME is what? It is the need of the Indian industry to give by the Indian government a separate identity. So in 2006, the first time Parliament has given an act of MSME 2006 that covers the various aspects, especially the payment to be made to the MSME in 45 days is the biggest breakthrough, where your payment of that MSME is being stuck down, then that unit or the purchaser must have to pay that in 45 days. Even after that, there are a lot of schemes like Samadhan, TRADS, bill discounting, all is available under the MSME ministry. You can see that MSME website, you can educate your clients to register over there, and it is really, really beneficial. What I recommend to all the members, that list out of all of your client, and they, if they have not got the Udyam registration, let them get if they are in the manufacturing or a service sector. That will help them a lot. So state subsidies available to the MSME units. When we hear the word subsidies, a lot of smile comes into the mind of the entrepreneurs, you know. Entrepreneurs are like subsidy madachana to aapne unit kari laya. So that is nowadays, even the promoter or the entrepreneur will be knowing more than you many a times. He will be reading all that stuff before you can even guide them. And there are n number of subsidies. So many a time it happens that he raises the question where you are not having a deep knowledge, and he will counter question you a lot. So I recommend all of you to either get experts consultation or you read before you advise, because it's very important, and that entrepreneur is also very smart. Second thing, all this GR, if you look at to the income tax, if you are practicing as an income tax consultant, you need to read around 2000 pages every year to get the updated knowledge. You have to see the case laws. If you see the accounting standards books, that is also running in more than 1000 pages. And here, if you see the NEI GR of any subsidy, not more than 50 pages, never. If you look at to the MSME 2020 Gujarat policies GR, it is just 19 pages, 19. That's a really wonderful. You need to concentrate on that. You learn everything and just read it once, very simple. even if you are not practicing as a consultant for the subsidies, you need to have the working knowledge of the subsidies. Because if he is putting up a unit, that entrepreneur is putting up a unit, and if you do not advise them whether the benefit will be available to him or not, or if, which format he should form the company, in such cases, there will be a mismatch or miscommunication. And at a later stage, you cannot correct it. Let me give you it by one of our practical examples. In one of the unit where I was visiting it even before starting of the construction, they have very good land. And that unit was falling under the red category of the GPCB. And when I visited the places, I have seen that the residential area is adjoining to that industrial area. Now I said that if you put up the whole project over here, GPCB is not going to give you that consent for the running of the business. And if that it does not give the consent to run the business, then you will not get the subsidy. So such type of, that is a very, very, very minor point, but it will affect financially very much to the organization. Let us take another example. In one of the example, well, the existing investment of the company was already the 5 crore rupees. Now there is a one condition that you can claim the subsidy benefit in case of expansion. However, that expansion should be at least 50% in investment. So they were putting up another unit at another area by the same company. However, the investment was just 1.5 crore rupees. So in such condition, we really need to give them advices that whether you want or interested to form the company in other family members' name or not. If it is possible, then the subsidy is possible. Otherwise, the criteria of expansion is not fulfilling and they will not get the subsidies. So I really get some of the cases where at the first stage, that consulting has never happened. And due to that, they directly come with the file that apply this subsidy, sir. And when I read everything, then I say that this is not possible. You cannot get this subsidy because there is some violation in some of the conditions. So whenever anyone asks, I humbly request, because that there are another 19 policy. Ignore that, but MSME 2020 is most important policy and which is under the most use. So at least read each word by word for that policy. And today we are going to discuss all that. And I hope that this will be sufficient for your working knowledge. Now, coming to the subsidy part, I really advise to all the client also while consulting the subsidy that just because of subsidy, if you are putting up the project, don't do that. First of all, see the practical viability of the project itself. Subsidy is beneficial in case of thin margin organization very much also. For high margin organizations, this is a bonus, what they get it. For the thin margin industry, For the thin margin industries, the interest cost, let's say they are giving the subsidy to 6-7% interest. And in such cases, just 2% they have to pay. So that becomes a viable, they're keeping more profits. Apart from the capital subsidy is also received on a one go immediately within a 1 year. And I really appreciate and agree with the Saurabh sir that the Gujarat is the only state where the disbursement of subsidy is so fast. Whenever you make any application, it goes into the portal and the industry commissioner has to act within 60 days, 60. There is an automatic system. If they have a query, that days will be deducted. Once you file the reply, their days will be started to be counted. And all the process should be done in 60 days. That is also the condition. So be it a clerk level, be it an inspector level, be it a regional manager level, or be it a general manager. Everything should be done in 60 days. So they are really working hard, I have seen so far. And let me give you a recent release by the government of Gujarat that the subsidy up to the May month in some of the talukas, districts, you can say it is a district wise. So district files a claim to the ministry and they released the fund. So Rajkot district has released the claim which is being approved up to May. So that is a wonderful thing. Even the Ahmedabad is also somewhere in April. They have released everything to that date. However, still the benefit that we, our nearby states is providing, like Maharashtra. Maharashtra is providing subsidy to MSME unit up to 100% based on their Mofussil area. But still, since the atmosphere in Gujarat is such that people are willing to reinvest over here only. And most important aspect is to give the local employment by the government. That is the intention by the government, that to promote this policy, and by that way, that can be done away, that the local employee is 85% is the local employee that you need to hire to in order to get this all these state subsidies. So let us start with so there are various schemes of subsidy by the Gujarat government, that is the MSME 2020 schemes. There are a large and thrust sector scheme. There is a textile scheme, textile 2019 policy, MSME shared development scheme, environmental protections measures, and startup schemes. Now, let us understand this scheme, its benefit, by way of one of the example. This is the real example of one of the, my client, who was in a Rajkot manufacturing cosmetic items on a rented premises, and he was paying around 1 lakh rupees of so rent. When they approached me for, they want to renovate that factory, and they also wanted to implement a new plant and machinery. I advise them to go for their own factory so that once they incur an expenditure on a renovation will be wasted. Here they can use their own building for a longer period. And we have explained them what is the benefit. Now look at to the cost of land, because he has went to a little Mofussil area, 20 lakh rupees is the land cost. Building was a 50 lakh rupees and plant and machinery 150 lakhs. So total cost of investment is 220 lakhs. Loan taken is 150. We know that we can't get the loan on the land, but on building and plant and machinery, he got at a 75%. So 150 lakh rupees loan he got. So his own investment was 70 lakh rupees. Now see the scenario. He was under the category 2 taluka. So he got 30 lakh rupees. It was under the previous scheme, so it was 25 lakhs. But considering that from now onwards, he can get 30 lakh rupees. So his own investment was 70 at day one, will reduce. You can get this is 1 year, within 1 year. If you have filed all your papers within the time, you will get this in 1 year. So 30 lakhs you can get back in a 1 year. So your effective investment would be just 40 lakh rupees. And what about the 150 lakh rupees loan? That is at hardly 2% interest rate. So you can't believe that is a, yeah, that is a, you know, if during the shutdown, he has 3 months closure of the business, then also this is viable because the cost to the company for the interest is very nominal. So he interest for 6 years, he will get around 28 to 31 lakhs based on his repayment schedule by the bank. So total benefit would be 58 lakhs to 61 lakhs. So many a times when I explain to some of friends or some of the clients or very new that has never taken any subsidy, the first question they ask that a subsidy aave sahib, kharekhar aave chhe? So really you need to do a hard work for the papers and paperwork, then 100% subsidy is being released by the state. You have to just check out whether you are not missing out on any condition or not. That's it. So benefits are 25% of the capital subsidy up to 35 lakhs, 9% up to 9% interest subsidy, 45 lakhs CGT MSE fee refunds, rent refund up to 1 lakh per annum, and 55% subsidy on shed construction to the private developers. Yes. So before we go into the details and technical aspect of the policy, let us understand what is the MSME. I give you a very simple example. Not an example, but very easy way to remember is that investment into plant and machinery, 1 crore, then 10 crore and 50 crore, 1, 10, 50, and turnover 5, 50 and 250. So earlier concept of services was a different, has been eliminated now, all whether service or a manufacturing. If your turnover is less than 5 crore, micro, 50 crore, then small, and 250 crore, then medium. And your investment into plant and machinery is 1 crore and below, micro, 10 crore and below, below 10 crore, then it's small, and below 50 crore, then it's a medium enterprise. So both the condition are to be satisfied. Suppose your turnover has increased, then again, you will fall under the next. Now here, let it be a little more interactive session. What is, here it is written where the investment in plant and machinery or equipment does not exceed 1 crore rupees. But how do you calculate that 1 crore rupees? Is it a cost or WDV? If it is a cost, then you have to include the GST cost or not, or the borrowing cost and etc. that we, as per accounting standard, we capitalize it before the starting of the company. That is to be included or not? So can you share your answers? Organization, can you unmute some who is interested, or you can write into the chat box.
Jatin bhai, they can write in the chat box.
Yeah, that would be better. Yes.
Yeah.
Cost without GST, basic cost. Okay. Without GST, cost without GST, WDV, okay. Okay, cost without GST, but included other incidental cost, okay. Only historical cost without borrowing cost, basic original cost, okay. So most of the answer, no, fair value is nowhere. It's very far away. No, no fair value. Basic. So most of the answers are coming out like a basic cost. Yes. Very interestingly, we read a lot about the income tax, but here it is just a two-pager gazette notifications. And that says that the concept has gone for the original cost. Now it is WDV. So the expression plant and machinery or the equipment of the enterprise shall have the same meaning as assigned to the plant and machinery in the Income Tax Rule 1962, framed under the Income Tax Act 1961, and shall include all tangible asset. Here the word is all tangible asset, other than the land and building and furniture and fittings. So now the definition has changed. So this is going to give a benefit to a lot of units. So now original cost concept has gone. Even they have, after this, a lot of confusion, they have issued a separate circular. Let us share the circular with all of you. Look. The OM has been issued on 6th of August 2020. And it says, it is clarified that the online form for the Udyam register captures the depreciated cost as on 31st March each year of the relevant previous year. And therefore, the value of the plant and machinery or equipment for all the purpose of the notification and for all the enterprises shall mean the written down value. As at the end of the financial year, is defined under the Income Tax Act and not the cost of acquisition or the original price, which was applicable in context to earlier classification criteria. So it is now very much clear. Now, don't misunderstand this definition with the definition given in GR of subsidy of any state. There may be a different definition under the state subsidy. So that definition you have to read to that GR of that government or whatever state government. But for the broad, for defining the MSME, now it is the WDV value that we need to consider. Even they have issued in the light of the above, RBI is being requested to revisit the circular. You know, you can say that they have given an instruction to the RBI that bank also have to look at whether it is an MSME or not. And their circular was a different. So what they have then after then done, let us see that also. Yes. So RBI, by August 21st, 2020, has issued the circular to all the bank that value of plant and machinery, as per now all the enterprise shall mean the written down value at the end of the financial year as defined under the Income Tax Act and not the acquisition or original price. So this is very much clear now that WDV. Here the WDV is also as per Income Tax Act and not under as per the Companies Act, not as per your books of account. Moreover, the word used is old tangible asset. So I personally believe that if you look into the block of asset, plant and machinery, there might be a vehicle, there might be a printer, computer, etc. All that will be now counted. It says that excluding the land and building and furniture and fixture. Then what about the new unit? Can anyone share their views? What about the new unit? This was okay. 31st March has gone and the balance sheet has been filed and ITR is available. What about the new unit? You can write in chat box, it's fine. How you will decide the for the new unit? Excellent, self-declared, you are right. You are right. Let us see that also. Investment value, yeah. So here, so this is, I'm talking about the Gazette that is published in June 26, 2020. So very simple, you do it by heart, this GR, this sorry, gazette notification. So calculation of investment of plant and machinery in case of new enterprises where no prior RTI is available, investment will be based on self-declaration of the promoter of the enterprises and such relaxation shall end after the 31st March of the financial year in which it files the first ITR. So what I believe that if your proposed investment is, let's say, 75 lakhs rupees, consider that under the micro. If you are really going to have investment in the same year, first year, let's say of 1.5 crore rupees, so it is a small unit, etc., etc. Some people are raising their hands, but if you have any questions, I think so we'll consider it at the end of the session. We'll have the question answer session. So that was about the MSME's definition. So I hope so. I made it clear to all the participants that the WDV value as per Income Tax Act to be considered. And for the, what about the turnover then? Then in case of a turnover, the total turnover of that organization company is to be taken care except the export. It says that export of goods or services or both shall be excluded while calculating the turnover of any enterprises, whether it is a micro, smaller, or medium enterprises. So for example, your turnover is, let's say, 60 crore rupees and 20 crore is an export out of 60 crore, then your turnover for the purpose of MSME Act would be 40 crore rupees only. Information in regards to turnover and export turnover for the enterprises shall be linked to the Income Tax Act or a GST Act. Right now, still not connected. However, they are fetching some of the data of the plant and machinery from, that is what I have seen. And even recently, they have issued the circular that Udyam, last Udyam Aadhaar that was discontinued was allowed to continue up to 31st December 2021. And also they have allowed that without the, previously they have said that all the only GST and can be eligible after 31st March 2021. However, that has been done away. They have said that as per GST law, if you are not required to register under the GST law, then also it is fine. You can get registration under the Udyam Aadhaar. In case, what about the new year? New year, there is no turnover. So what I believe is look into the criteria for the first year for the plant and machinery only. The registration is very simple on the Udyam registration site. It's very easy process, and in a day or a two, you will get the Udyam registration. You can generate, update, and print the UAM. Suppose at the later stage, you have increased the investment. At a later stage, date of commencement has been wrongly written by you. You can change it. So all these options are available. And later on, you can print that amended Udyam Aadhaar also. Then what is the upward change? There might be a situation that your investment may increase and your investment may decrease, or your sales may increase or sales may decrease. Then how you count that? So in case of an upward change, they are a little relaxed in giving the continuous status. 1 year more relaxation has been given. It says that it maintains the prevailing status till the expiry of 1 year from the close of the year of the registration. So for example, right now my investment in plant and machinery is 50 lakh, and my turnover is also below 5 crore rupees. Right now I am a micro enterprises and I have registered today itself. By the 31st, just let's say in a July month, I have made an investment of 1 crore more. Then 1 crore 50 lakh rupees is my investment into plant and machinery. So I fall under the micro to small category. So, but this gives me a relaxation 1 year from the registrations year end on 31st March 2022. The 1 year more relaxation, so 31st March 23, till 31st March 23, my unit will be still considered as a micro enterprises. And then after, it will be a small enterprises. The same way, more benefit while you are downgraded. It gives the immediate effect. How? Immediate effect from the next financial year. It says that downward change in such cases, continue the present category till the closure of the financial year. And after the closure of the financial year, change immediately from the 1st April. So suppose right now I am a small enterprises. My investment is, let's say, into machinery is 1.5 crore rupees. Or let's say my turnover is more than 5 crore rupees. My turnover has come down this year, or I have sold some asset. My WDV value has gone down to 1 crore rupees. So on 31st March, it will be down. From the next day, 1st April, I will be considered as a micro unit. So this is the basics about the MSME. Now let us talk the main topic, that is the Gujarat MSME Policy 2020. From From 7th of August 2020, this policy has been announced by our Honorable Chief Minister Vijayabhai Rupani. This is applicable for next 5 years. Here, the most important aspect is the first disbursement date of your term loan, as well as the production date of this entity. So if your first disbursement date is after 7th of August 2020, then you will be eligible under this policy. And if your production should be during the, your starting of the production should be during the operative period of the scheme. Before we go into a little details, let us see what are the definitions that has been given in the MSME 2020 policy. New enterprises. What is new enterprises? Which commencement of a commercial production during the operative period of the scheme. So any company, any organization that has started the commercial productions after 7th of August 2020, for the first time, it is considered as a new enterprises. And existing enterprises means which has started the commencement of a commercial production before the GR has been announced, that is before the 7th of August 2020. Then expansion. What you considered as an expansion is 50% or more investment into new GFCI, gross fixed capital investment, is only considered as an expansion. So any amount lesser than that will not be considered as an expansion and will not be eligible for subsidy. Out of which at least 60% in plant and machinery. So out of that expansion, for example, presently my investment into a factory is, let's say, 2 crore rupees. That is also gross fixed capital investment. So here, don't mix that WDV concept here. Here, gross fixed capital investment has been defined under the MSME policy, and it says that GFCI means the cost of your investment into building, plant and machinery, and other assets. You have to check the whole as a whole. And now my total investment is 2 crore rupees. And if I am intending to do a new investment of 1 crore or more than 1 crore, then and only then it is satisfying the criteria of the expansion, and then and only then I will be getting the subsidy. However, out of that investment of 1 crore, minimum I need to do 60% into the plant and machinery. So if I am expanding just 100% onto the building, 1 crore rupees, then also again I will not be eligible for the subsidy. Here, for as a chartered accountant, for us, it is very difficult to find out the GFCI as per the their criteria. They ask for the chartered accountant certificate for the GFCI while you are putting up this subsidy applications. What we as a practice in our office do is that for the companies, you can easily get, because there is a gross block is running into the company's balance sheet. So that's fine. But what about the partnership or a proprietorship firm? I recommend all of you that you ask the company's balance sheet since beginning, including the fixed asset schedule. Put it into the spreadsheet. Let it be a 20 years data. Okay. Let it be whatever years the company has been. If it is not available, be reasonable. Okay. Take an Excel. Let, for example, since 1994, the company is running 94, 95, 95, 96. Make a whole Excel sheet. Take every fixed asset that is being added into the year, exclude that borrowing cost part, okay? And that you come to the conclusion of total fixed cash capital, GFCI, gross fixed capital investment. In our CA certificate, we always attach that sheet also, from which source we come to the GFCI. This is more important when the case is of a borderline case. For example, as I've said that my investment, existing investment was 2 crore and new investment is 1 crore and 1 lakh. In such borderline cases, they are very keen to observe all the details. Even the DIC is demanding the income tax returns also, of last 3-4 years, 5 years, even they are demanding the audit and balance sheet also. So, but however, if it is not like say present investment is 5 lakh rupees and I am investing now new as a 2 crore rupees. So it's very easy, but still go the method of finding out the whole GFCI since beginning. Okay. Then thereafter, forward integration, backward integration, and diversification. Forward integrations, the word itself indicates that if any finished goods has been manufactured by us, any value addition has been done to that finished goods, or the finished good has been taken as an input into the other project, that is called as a forward integration. Backward integration, if we put up an any project which produces the raw material for us, for this project, that is a backward integration. And diversification, that I am right now manufacturing is, let's say, automobile, and now I am starting in the same company a food industry, that is totally a diversification. Then the term loan from the bank and financial institution is only eligible for subsidy under the Gujarat MSME 2020, excluding the NBFC. So NBFC are not eligible for the subsidy, like Electronica Finance. There are various companies which provide finance on the machinery without any collateral. So borrower or the entrepreneur is very much interested, very easy process. However, the loss to him would be that he will not get any subsidy from the State Department. Then the pipeline enterprises. If any enterprise has taken the loan before the 7th of August, but could not start the production, then what? Then they have to start the production before the 31st March 21, and they can be considered as a pipeline enterprises and given the subsidy under the 2015 policy. However, if they want to opt to apply into this policy, they can apply if the production has been started in this policy period, loan has been taken partly in previous, partly under this now new regime. In such cases, subsidy will be available only onto the part of the term loan which is being disbursed after the 7th of August. So you have to check if the majority portion has been taken in a previous scheme, then go for the previous scheme. That is obvious. So this is about the basic concepts and basic definitions. Then we come to what is the capital subsidy that is being offered under this MSME policy 2020. Taluka 1, 25%, Taluka 2, 20, and Taluka 3, 10%. And if your fixed capital investment is over a 10 crore, then 10 lakhs, 7.5 lakhs, and 5 lakhs respectively. Now let us see which taluka that they are referring. Okay, so this is the notification has been given by the Gujarat government regarding the taluka. If you look at to Ahmedabad, category 1, maximum subsidy in Dholera, Dethroj, and Danduka. That is 25%, 35 lakh rupees. Viramgam, 20% and 30 lakh rupees. And Bavada, Dodka, Sanand, all are 10% only and maximum 10 lakh rupees for the MSME. Fixed capital investment less than 10 crore. If 10 more than 10 crore, 5 lakh extra. So 15 lakhs for the category 3. So maximum will be falling under this category 3 would be getting 10 lakhs rupees plus interest subsidy of 5 lakh rupees. Let us say nearby other, you can see this annexure is available onto the Gujarat's website, Gujarat Government Subsidy Department website, and so on. So the intention is that which talukas are less developed, they want to give more to to that taluka and less to the developed talukas. Then condition, apply within 1 year from the date of first disbursement on or before the commencement of commercial production, whichever is later. Need to upload all documents and submit reimbursement loan. Now here, I think so yesterday also some of the participant has raised the question that suppose I have applied after 1 year, then what will happen? In such case, the view of the DIC is very strict that if you have applied after even one day, if you have applied after 1 year and 1 day of from the first disbursement, you will not be eligible for the capital subsidy. However, you can get this interest subsidy for the remaining period of time. Let's say for the remaining four years, you can get that from the date of applications to the remaining period. You can get that interest subsidy, but no for the capital subsidy. However, suppose your first disbursement has been taken, let's say in last September 2020, was the date on which you have taken a first disbursement. By the next September 21, you need to apply. However, the production has not been started by September 21. That let us say it is starting in December 21. In such case, before starting of the commercial production, you can apply. So in case of some constructions is going on and there may be a delay. So in such cases, you can apply before the commencement of commercial production. Then reimbursement of loan. Can anyone share this view about the reimbursement of the loan? I'm eligible for the reimbursement. Suppose, let's say I already purchased the machinery, installed the machinery, and after 6 months, I need a fund and I'm hampered due to the, let's say, COVID. And I applied for the loan to the, let's say, nationalized bank or a private bank, and they, on my machinery invoice, after 6 months, give me a term loan onto that, reimbursement of the term loan. Am I eligible for subsidy? No. With 6 months, yes. Yes, reimbursement can be done. Yes, cooperative bank loan eligible. No. So quite 50-50 ratio are coming out. Here, don't mix the concept with the CLCSS. Under the CLCSS, there is reimbursement is not allowed. Under the TUPS, reimbursement is not allowed. Under this Gujarat State MSME 2020 policy, reimbursement of loan is allowed. You will be eligible for the subsidy. And they have written wonderfully that the loan should be taken within 1 year from the commencement of commercial production, not from the invoice value, invoice debt, machine purchase debt. 1 year from the commencement of commercial operations, if you have taken a term loan for that particular machinery, you will be eligible for the subsidy. It's not a 6 months, it's a 1 year. Then interest subsidy. Again, same taluka wise, 7%, 6% and 5% maximum 35 lakhs, 30 lakhs and 25 lakhs for 7 years, for 6 years and 5 years. So taluka one, if you are doing, say, let's say any project in Dholera, you will get 25% capital subsidy maximum over there plus 7% for 7 years. So that's a massive benefit. Moreover, 1% additional to the women and differently able and registered starters, and 1% additional to the young below the age of 35. So that's like any young lady that is being incorporating the project, and then she is also in Taluka 3, then also 5 plus 1 plus 1. So 7% she will be eligible to get the subsidy. However, don't mix. If she is a woman, she is a differently abled and she is also below 35, then 1% is not added. Sorry, total 3% will not added. Maximum 2% will be added. Moreover, the enterprise must have to bear the 2% interest per annum. This was not in previous policy. In a previous policy, we have claimed many a time a lady entrepreneur up to 9% interest subsidy, where the bank was charging 8.5% interest only. So we have to give in writing that since interest is less than what is eligible, you allow us 100% interest, that's it. 88.5% interest is charged, you allow us that much only. But however, under this new policy, they have make it very clear that you have to bear the 2% cost. And installation of solar power plant for captive consumption in premises, only interest subsidy will be available. Don't mix with the solar standalone project and solar project for the captive power consumption. So if any factory is installing the solar rooftop to conserve their own electricity bill, and they are using their own generated power into their own premises, then that is called as a captive consumption. And that captive consumption, only interest subsidy. Moreover, there is not written that here the expansion criteria should be fulfilled. So if investment is 5 crore, that new investment into this power plant is, let's say, 50 lakh rupees only, then also it will be eligible as per my view. Moreover, the installation is also considered. So I recommend all the friends to advise your client who have really have, if you are doing an auditing and your staff is getting this, he is paying like 40 lakh rupees, 30 lakh rupees as an electricity bill, check whether it is viable to install onto the rooftop or nearby area and use that captively. Then bank will provide them at interest of 8% is right now going on. You will get 5 to 6% back. So hardly 2%. So capital, your cost of funding is very low, and you can advise in that way to all your client. And what about the standalone project? This is about the captive consumption. So standalone project itself is a generating a manufacturing of a power itself. Hence, it will be considered as a separate project. Capital and interest, both subsidy will be available as per my view. So you can apply under the new policy. There are a lot of people have recently applied to this JEDA for this direct supply to them. And they are going to install a new solar power plants, a small one megawatt, et cetera, et cetera. All that will be eligible for the capital and interest subsidy. So this was all about the manufacturing sector. Then what about the service sector? Only interest subsidy will be available to the service sector, no capital subsidy. And that too, they have given a list of industry of that service sector which will be eligible. Same rate as of the manufacturing, and term loan on machinery, equipment, furniture, and fixture will be available, not for land and building. In a manufacturing, building was eligible. Building loan, if you have taken, then you can get that subsidy. But under the service sector, only machinery and equipment and furniture and fixture to be considered. Only new MSME service sector. This was a surprising word that is being used in the policy, that only new MSME service sector. So specifically, we have asked to the help desk of the government of Gujarat that what do you mean by that? They literally replied that only new will be eligible. Existing MSME unit will not be eligible. Existing MSME service sector will not be eligible. Still, we should try to put up some of the files and let us see what this time they take. So must have the service tax registration. I think it seems just extracted from some earlier policy. It should be a GST. Then the SWAPAC license is a compulsory if it is into the municipal area. Then the annexure B listed entities like a financial services sector, logistic, etc. They must have to give the minimum employment to 10 persons to get this subsidy. List of services like a financial services, a chartered accountant services can be included into that financial services, health services, transportation and logistic, and many more as per the list. Under that GR, that list is being provided. Condition for interest subsidy. Either from, you can claim that interest subsidy either from the date of first disbursement or from the commencement of commercial production date. So it is at your option. So you check it out, which is more beneficial. I recommend to go by the first disbursement date. Apply within 1 year from the date of first disbursement on or before the commencement of commercial production, whichever is later, or that much period will lapse, as we have already discussed. And term loan reimbursement is the same. It is also eligible for the interest subsidy. General condition, no, not from NBFC. You cannot get the subsidy if you have taken a loan from NBFC. Only new building, plant and machinery should also be a new one. So when you applied for the subsidy, the district industry commissioner allot this file to the inspector, and he is going to visit that factory, and he can come to know whether the plant and machinery is new or not. If it is not new, you will not be eligible for the subsidy. However, old imported plant and machinery is specifically allowed under this policy. GPCB consent is a must to get this subsidy. Mind well, whenever you start consulting, just check this as a first point, because the DIC is very strict on this point. They don't want to give the benefit to the unit which are not complying the GPCB norms. So check whether it is a white category. If it is a white category, then it is not, you are not required to take any permission. Then attach that along with your application, then it would be fine. If it is not white, then let's say it's a green, orange, whatever, and the, as per the rules, then you need to take the CTE and CCA. There are two concepts. CTE means consent to establishment, and another is CCA, consolidated consent and authorization. So when you start to make the factory, you have to apply for the CTE. If the CTE has been received, when you start the production, you have to apply again for the CCA. And this DIC will issue that subsidy only if you have a CCA, final consent. Then and only then they will give the subsidy. 85% local employees is one of the most important criteria. Now, we really gone into the deep that what is the local employee? If you say that 85% of the local employee and my employee is residing originally from Bihar, however, he is residing in Gujarat since 20 years, then what? In such cases, they have given a notification that 15 years or more, if any person is residing in Gujarat for 15 years or more, will be considered under the local employee. Remain in production for 7 years. So whenever you take this benefit, your company must be remaining in production for 7 years. Otherwise, the government can take back the capital as well as interest subsidy. Forward, backward, and diversifications. So if you have done forward integration, backward integration, or a diversification, in such cases, that criteria of expansion of 50% will reduce to 25%. I don't understand what is the logic behind this, but still, if you've done the forward integration, then expansion 50% criteria will reduce to 25% and you will be eligible for the subsidy. Then most important part is the factory land. Non-agricultural order is very important. You have to read it line by line. If the non-agricultural order says that in this land is being converted into non-agricultural for the purpose of industry, then and only then you will get the subsidy from the DIC. If it is for the residential purposes, then also you will not get the subsidy, since the intention of the land use has been changed. So this GPCB factories documentation all need to be checked at a day one. Even the which form you should, new proprietor, partnership, running company, new joint venture, that is to be seen at a first stage. So always give a full attention to this aspect also. Then come under the CGTMSE fee reimbursement. Under this policy, 100% of the CGTMSE fee of the term loan will be reimbursed to the department, by the department to the unit. So right now, the CGTMSE fee is shooted like anything. They are charging 2.5%, blah, blah. Let's say 1 crore rupees term loan is going on. They will be easily charging 2.5 lakhs and plus service tax. And in such cases, you can apply for the reimbursement of the CGTMSE fees. However, Rajkot DIC take a view that they are not providing CGT MSC fees for the cash credit. Obviously, it is for the term loan only. ERP assistance. So if you are visiting some of the factories and you are really can advise that you can install that ERP, then check it out. 65% of the capital cost of the ERP will be reimbursed by the state subsidy department, maximum 1 lakh rupees. This benefit should be encroached. Quality certification, 50% of the fee and cost of testing equipment for the BSI, ISI, WHO, Hallmark, etc. 50% of the fee, maximum 10 lakh will be provided. Not eligible for the subsidy if certification is required as a part of statutory provisions. I don't understand why this is put up. If it is statutorily you need to do, then no subsidy. Voluntary if you are doing, then the quality certification subsidy will be given. Apply within 1 year of the date of issue of certificate, and renewal of the certificate will not be eligible for the subsidy. Then information and communication. 65% expenses relating to information and communication technology networking with the cloud computing. If your client is interested in networking this cloud computing, then 65% of the cost will be reimbursed, maximum 5 lakh rupees. Just do it. Where the organization of a mid-level, and let's say they want to tie up with the Google, Oracle, etc., then the networking with the hardware for assessing the cloud computing will be eligible for 65% subsidy. Then technology acquisition. Let's say nowadays it is very common that from the European countries or from US countries, we acquire some of the technology, and many of these are untouched because you come to know very later stage that technology deal has happened. Always give your advice to your client that they are getting 65% subsidy for the purchase of that technology. Acquisition of appropriate technology from the recognized institution or from the Indian company or from the foreign company. Maximum 50 lakhs will be allowed. A patented technology, even from an Indian company you are purchasing. Let's say if you are purchasing for 80 lakh rupees, 50 lakhs straight away will be given by the State Department as a subsidy to you. Patent registrations. So 75% of the cost of the patent and maximum 25 lakhs per applicant. If you have applied 5 patents, 5 expenses will be done, even it is allowed. Per person, maximum 25 lakhs will be given. Maximum fee for attorney should be 50,000 in national patent and for 2 lakhs for international patent. Other assistance, 75% of cost of energy and water audit. Maximum rupees 50,000, 25% of cost of equipment recommended by the audit agency. Suppose water audit has been done and they recommended that you installed, let's say 50 lakh rupees equipment, then you will get 12.5 lakhs easily under that assistance. SME IPO, you will get 25% reimbursement of the expenses, maximum 5 lakh rupees. Power connection charges, 35% of the charges. This does not include the deposits, maximum 5 lakh rupees. And rent assistance, a very small unit, let's say is paying 15-20,000 as a rent for the whole year, let's say it's paying 2.4 lakh rupees, 65% and maximum 1 lakh. So you will get easily 1 lakh rupees as a rent assistance from the MSME department under the MSME 2020 policy. So this was all about the MSME policy. Before we start question answer session, let me throw some of the light onto the very important other policies also where the MSME can claim the benefit. The one of that is that assistance for environment protections. If anything that is you are installing to protect the environment, then 35% of the cost of machinery, implementation of cleaner production technology and maximum 35 lakhs will be given. 25% of the cost of machinery and other environment management, pollution control equipment, and 50% in case of ZLD, zero liquid discharge system. So you cannot throw away your wastewater. You treat it and make it a total cleaner water. That is called a ZLD plant. And if you are installing that ZLD plant, 50% of cost of equipment will be reimbursed or given as a subsidy by the state department. However, all this has been sanctioned by state level committee. So it's not an easy job, again, to convince them. Then the scheme for the private developer of SAID for the MSME. So micro and small enterprises, which are going to start a factory over there, and if any developer construct for them, here the condition is, let's say he constructs 50 units, but the per unit should not be more, should be from 50 to 100 square meter only. So that is for the mini shed only. Then in such cases, 55% subsidy on the cost of land, building and other structures. Here, first time the land is included. That is, I mean, in other policies, never no subsidy is given on a land. Here for the shed development, subsidy will also be given on to the land, building cost and other structure. So let's say for that 50 units, he constructs for, let's say, 10 crore rupees, including the land cost, then he will be getting subsidy of 5 crore from the state government. However, he can sell only to the micro and small unit. What about the large and trust sector? As per the taluka-wise, taluka one category, general sector, 10% fixed capital subsidy, 12% fixed capital subsidy. Previously, it was linked with the GST. Now they have dealing with the GST, straight away capital subsidy will be given, no interest subsidy for the large sector. Here, for example, now the limit of the MSME has been raised to 50 crore investment. So let's say 45 crore, if any company is investing, then you have to check whether there is a more benefit under the MSME policy or under the larger policy. Because under the larger policy also, the MSME unit can apply for that subsidy. Then scheme for the textile value chain. Textile unit must have to apply under this only. Even the MSME textile unit have to apply under this. He cannot apply for the MSME policy 2020. We have strongly opposed this point. This policy has come in 2019. We are restricting the MSME units of the textile under the MSME policy that you have to apply under the textile only. And the biggest drawback is here under the textile policy, there is no capital subsidy, only interest subsidy is there. So we have strongly represented, and I think so, a lot of representatives, including the South Textile Association from Surat, from Ahmedabad Textile Association, and even from the Jaipur, has been represented to the state government. We are hoping some changes, and I request if any member is aware about this, keep on, if you have good contact with the Textile Association, anyone, get back to me personally. I really wanted to take up this matter and want to give larger benefit to the textile unit also. Under the textile policy, weaving, knitting, dyeing, and technical textile and made-ups are covered. Spinning, ginning, how now dispensed with this new policy. 6% interest to MSME units for 5 years, maximum 20 crore. Here the limit is very higher for the interest subsidy, but that is a beneficial to the larger unit, not to the beneficial to the MSME units. And 4 to 6% based on the employment to the large enterprise will be given by the textile value chain subsidy policy. So that is all about the major practical aspect of the subsidies and the scheme that is directly affecting to our practice area. So now the let us open the forum for the question and answer. If anyone has any questions, any comment, raise in your chat box. And I request all of you that if anyone is in contact with the Textile Association, do contact me personally. Okay, is anyone from the branch available?
Yes, sir.
So shall I start to read from chat box directly? Is it okay? The same way, no?
Yes, absolutely, sir. Yeah, you can read from question answer.
Sir, even Prakshar can help you as you think deem fit, sir.
Okay, I'll start it. That's it. Going slow, is the interest subsidy available for plant generating biogas from the animal plant waste? If you can convince that it is a product, you are manufacturing is a product, then yes. The same way there were a different view while some were applying for the electricity generating power plant for the subsidy. We have said that since it's a power is a product, you will be eligible. And we got one sanction that it is eligible. So again, the gas from my point of view is the product and you will get the subsidy under the MSME 2020. Then Pranav Shah, from where we get list of services sector eligible under the scheme? Sir, just type it MSME 2020 policy, you will get it. Or you can search ifp.gujarat.gov.in. Can you throw some light on the CSE, CLCSS? It is already discontinued since 31st March 20 and I think so, as per my last communication with the ministry's people, they are revising that policy and I'm hopeful that from the retrospective effect, it will come. But right now, fingers are closed. What if after the subsidy, we repay the loan? What if after the subsidy? Oh, it's quite, it happens that suppose like say 5 years term loan you have taken first year, you have taken a loan, second year you have repaid fully, that's fine. You will not get the interest subsidy because you have not paid the interest. Capital subsidy, you can get it easily. The condition is that 7 years you have to continue the unit. Kindly share the PPT, branch will be given. Kindly share the website address from where you can download the circular for the subsidies. Sir, dig it out, IFP portal of Gujarat government and there is industry and mine department, imb.gujarat.gov.in.
Sir, with your kind permission, there are a few questions in the question answer chat box. If I can...
That will also taken care. Yeah, that will also taken care. No problem. How many times subsidy can be claimed in same PAN number? It is under the GR, it is written that one time expansion will be allowed. One time expansion diversification, that. Now suppose 2020 policy, under the 19 you have claimed, sorry, 2015 policy, you have claimed one time. Now under the 2020, it's a different policy. So under the 2020, you can again apply for the subsidy. If new cooperative society is incorporated for the purpose of Gaushala, are they eligible? No. Sir, if it is not eligible, it is not a manufacturing unit. For services, if we considered as a services, there is a specific list, it is not there, Gaushala. Sir, if loan is at 8%, we are in Taluka 1, owner is 35, okay, means 7, yes, okay, or we get, but minus 2 to karna padega aapko. So suppose minus 2 is minimum 2% you have to bear. So suppose you are getting 8% subsidy and your term loan is 10% or above, so you will get full. But if your term loan is sanctioned at a rate of 9%, then 2% you have to bear and 7% reimbursement will be given. What is the meaning of SME, small and medium enterprises? New hospital will be eligible for any subsidy? There are two policies. Number one, health policy 2016 that is going to expire in 2021 recently. There is you have to check that policy also. And for hospital, under the service category, they have allowed for the interest subsidy. Healthcare is allowed to claim the interest subsidy under the 2020 policy. However, the main condition is that new unit and GST registration. If the original investment in plant 32 crores, WD is 20 crore, and the whole expansion machinery is 20 crores purchased, expansion subsidy benefit available. Okay, so original here for the state subsidy, gross fixed capital investment. Forget about the plant and machinery. Gross fixed capital investment. So you have to see the balance sheet, exclude the land. Apart from that, everything will be covered. That is at the original price. And 50% of that, if it is more than 20 crore is more than that figure, then you will be eligible. Can we get the CGTMSE fee refund if the CGTMSE loan taken is cancelled within 4 months due to non-operational of the unit? The unit has to be in operation for 7 years. So in between also, after 3 years, unit has been closed down, no subsidy will be given. How to apply for subsidy, whether the whole process is online? Yes, I have seen the IFP portal, everything is online. You can register in your own name also. Just go for the learning purposes, you visit that site. Sir, if the loan is 8% in taluka ownership, I think so I have taken this question. Can we explain more about the electricity duty benefit? I'm not practicing onto that. However, for the new unit, it is eligible. Electricity duty is 10 to 15% is eligible. What if the bank is charges both being nationalizing? What if bank is changes both being nationalized banks? Absolutely. If the bank has been changed from one bank to another bank, even in the module of the website of the subsidy of the state government, you can apply that there is a change in bank. You can, however, that term loan ending balance should be the same as for the opening balance. It should not be that you changed as a mortgage loan and et cetera, et cetera. It should be term loan only. Is there is any subsidy available to unit doing mineral exploration, mining? I don't think so, no. IMD, yeah, website address is right. But if existing MSME goes for expansion and investment goes above 50 crore in plant and machinery, then is it eligible for interest subsidy? For the large and thrust sector that we have already discussed, if existing MSME goes for expansion, actually status has been seen on the date of sanction of the subsidy. So on that date, you have made an investment of 45 crore, that date is seized. Then after you will get for subsidy for 5 years, okay? Because then it will be interest only continuously. If maximum ceiling benefit once obtained, again in expansion benefit can be claimed, dear, it will be a different term loan then. Then again, the ceiling will be a new ceiling, okay? What about the cooperative bank loan? Yeah, cooperative is eligible. Is plastic policy extended? So far, not in my knowledge, no. CLCSS 2 is open or closed. Not extended CLCSS as of now. How to benefit to audio vision services? How to benefit to the audio vision service? I didn't get this question. What is the criteria for the subsidy to the startups? Startup, there is a separate policy for the startup. 30 lakh rupees will be given under that. Or if it is under the manufacturing, you can claim very well under this MSME policy. And central government benefit for the income tax exemption, etc., is already there. GST is not applicable to healthcare. I know it, GST is not applicable, but they have made it mandatory to get this benefit. However, I have not done the practical experience. You try it out. Better you take it and just file nil filing. Does the CGTMSE fee may also be claimed for the reimbursement in case of term loan sanctioned in PMEGP scheme? Does the CGTMSE fee may also be claimed? If you have taken PMEGP, you can very well apply under the MSME 2020 policy. Both the benefit you can get. For subsidy to large and thrust sector, is online portal functioning? Still not, I think so. Provide information for the transfer of plant from one place to another place with the old and new machinery. Provide information for transfer. You can ping me personally because I need to understand what is the project, how much cost, what is the new machinery investment has been done. Rent assistant available to restaurant. Restaurant is nowhere into the service category. If subsidy is stopped due to unit discontinuation, what about the subsidy given in the previous year? They can be taken back. Can the interest subsidy benefit available if we may balance transfer of live loan to another bank? Yeah, absolutely. Interest subsidy benefit will be available. However, if you go to NBFC, no benefit. Rent assistant available to restaurant, no. Sir, whether the GST subsidy available 70% cost of investment due to date of extend or not? That I2I policy is expiring on 24th July 2021. Now only 1 month is remaining. Check it out. For the large, it is beneficial. It is only for the large unit it is beneficial, and only state GST has been paid will be released. Assistant to in rent to SME benefit to service provider and trading entity? Not, nothing for trading. NEA period for applying for interest subsidy? Definitely yes, in 1 year, but if you have lapsed and you apply for after 2 years, 2 years interest subsidy will not be given, only remaining 3 year will be subsidy will be given. If the CGTMSE fees on term loan not claimed along with the capital subsidy, can it claim it now? No. Loan from private bank is eligible. Here, so that CGTMSE person may contact me personally. I am actually represented this matter to the MSME commissioner in past. Loan from private bank is eligible for subsidy. Private bank is absolutely eligible. Only NBFC is not eligible. If 75% trading and 25% is manufacturing, can we give the benefit? If you are installing machinery, then and only then subsidy is going to be received. And if you are installing the machinery, then it will be manufacturing. Then there is no concept like trading or manufacturing, okay? Any suggestion for the new practitioner who is newly entering into the subsidy services? Yeah, absolutely. Read, go, visit to the DIC, learn the new things. It's really a wonderful practice to do. Or you can join me as a partner. If the partner of the LLP or NRI, shall it be eligible for a subsidy? Under the subsidy, there is no criteria that NRI is not allowed. Even they are giving the subsidy to the Ford, which is an American company. Why they will not allow you? Okay, now I'll see the question and answer. Under that tab, can any major changes explain wind policy? I think so, not for me. If existing MSME goes for expansion and investment above 50 crore in plant, is the unit is eligible for interest? If existing MSME goes for expansion and investment above 50 crore in plant and machinery. I didn't get this point. Sir, at present banks have put on hold sanction and disbursement of loan for the solar park due to doubt of the subsidy not issued by the government. For this, you can show them the new, recently the solar park policy has been announced 2021, and it clearly on the 6 or 7 page, it says that consider under the MSME 2020 policy. Show them that. Which document is to be given for the proof of 15 years of residence of Gujarat? I don't know. I think so. Their rent agreement, their present address, their present, if you have their residential place, you can give that. For expansion unit, the gross investment means value except moving. Okay. How can I CGT message? Chat box, let me get back to chat box. I think so, in chat box I have covered. Let me know if I have missed out anything. Still, if you have any questions. How to benefit to the audio? Your question is not understood to me. How to benefit to audio vision services? Check out the service category. I don't think so. Audio vision services has been given under that list of category. 20 services has given. Check out under that. Or you can ping me on my email. I'll get back to you. Nilay is asked that, can you please specify whether the solar interest subsidy cover is an MSME policy? Is there is another separate policy? Sir, I have already clarified that as per my opinion, the solar can apply as an MSME unit itself under the MSME 2020 policy. Yes. Under the 2015, they have already given the subsidy. And by the way of solar policy 2021, it is clearly says that for the subsidy, check the MSME 2020 policy. Provide the information for transfer of plant, or if you are not getting this, Nilay, you can text me personally or mail me. We will get clarified from the MSME cell, okay? Provide information for transfer of plant from one place to another place with old or new machines. So from transferring from one place to another place, there is no subsidy. But that is what I understood. However, if you falling under the expansion criteria, making a new investment, making a new building, and if you are satisfying that expansion criteria, then the MSME 2020 subsidy will be available. Recently, automobile dealers are covered under the MSME. Is there is any benefit available to auto dealers? That is what I believe is a trading activity, service in some part by way of the servicing industry. You need to check out the service list is covered for this automobile or not. But definitely it's not a manufacturing unit. So no capital and interest subsidy. Hotel industry covered, hotel industry is not covered. Hotel industry is a separate policy. 2015, that has been expired under the 2020. And recently the tourism department has reviewed it and sent it to the ministry for the revision. It was asked before you clarified, sir. Okay. Whether subsidy will be available if disbursement is made in old policy and production is done in new policy. Yes, there is a concept like pipeline enterprises, and you should start production before 31st March 2021. If the agriculture machinery producer wants their customer to claim the subsidy, how they claim proceed to that? First of all, for agricultural machinery producer, if they are they want their for own, they can apply for their own. If that machinery to be installed at other places, or let's say under the farming, farming is not covered under the industrial policy. Farming is covered under the ICADUT's various policies, like they are providing subsidy for the tractor, subsidy for the huller, subsidy for that and this. Then you have to apply under that category, and I don't practice onto that. Private limited is eligible for MSME subsidy? Absolutely, yes. Even private limited, joint venture, proprietor, partnership, joint venture is any other mode also eligible. What if whole disbursement is taken and commencement of commercial production is yet to start? Then whole disbursement means what? They considered the first disbursement date only. So the first disbursement date is to be looked out. If you have not taken a disbursement, then it will fall under the 2020 policy only. How many times an existing unit can claim the benefit in the new industrial policy? Existing unit only one time under the 20 policy. One time in forward integration and then again diversification? I think so. No, they're clarifying. It is right. Rightly in the GR, it is said only one for expansion or forward or backward integration. Any specific policy for pharma industry and fertilizer industry, Amazon Pharma? Pharma that is already expired, I think. So when policy was there, it is being expired and I am not aware about the new and fertilizer. And then I think so MSME would be the best one. If the disbursement is taken before 7th of August, but the commercial production is yet to start, if you miss the deadline 31st March 21, I think it is very difficult for you to get any benefit. Whether the capital subsidy is eligible? Whether the capital subsidy is eligible on the term loan for building and machinery both, if opted for modernization, since condition is 25% is existing machinery, else only interest subsidy is eligible. No, capital subsidy is eligible, yeah. Just on a later note, RVCS get any subsidy? CA, actually, I really wanted to put one file for the existing enterprise who is doing a new office. But however, the GR itself says that only new service sector will be given. So any young chartered accountant who passed out and want to do this practice under the financial sector, we will be covered and we are eligible for subsidy for the term loan on the plant and machinery, furniture and fixtures. However, there is a confusion about whether only new or existing can available. So if anyone want to do a new office, I'll do them I will do that first file for you.
Okay, Jatin sir. So I think we have taken so many questions, and if still any question remains, they can personally mail you or text you, so they can be answered later on. And now I would request CA Nirav Agarwal sir to please offer vote of thanks.
Thank you, Prakshal bhai. So International MSME Day, almost 600 participants and two stalwart sandwiching members on the topic. Wow, we could not have asked for better Sunday than this. I, CA Nirav Agarwal, on behalf of Ahmedabad branch and on behalf of all the members present, would like to take this opportunity to propose a heartiest vote of thanks and like to express our sincere gratitude to both the eminent speakers of the day. Thank you, Saurabh sir, and thank you, Jatin sir, for sharing rich insight of the subject with the members. It was pleasure listening to you on the topic. I would be failing in my duty if I failed to thank all the members, participants present in the session and making it a huge success. Thank you, members, for being present and making this a huge success. Now, happy Sunday evening to all the members present. Thank you, all of you, for joining.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.